In this lesson, we'll evaluate the given expressions using the order of operations below. Notice for the first expression, we have subtraction and multiplication. Referring to the order of operations, we always multiply and divide before we add and subtract, which indicates the first step is to determine 2 times 4, which is 8. Expression simplifies to 12 minus 8, which is equal to 4. For the next expression, the first step is to simplify inside the innermost grouping symbols. We have brackets, and then inside the brackets we have parentheses, indicating the first step is to determine 12 minus 7, which is 5, giving us the quantity in brackets 6 plus 2 times 5, all times 3. Still working inside the grouping symbols or brackets now, we have addition and multiplication. Again, we know we multiply and divide before we add and subtract. The next step is 2 times 5, which is 10, giving us in the brackets the quantity 6 plus 10, all times 3. So working inside the brackets, we have 6 plus 10, which is 16. If we want, we can drop the brackets now and just write 16 times 3. Or we can still leave the brackets if we want. 16 times 3 is equal to 48. And now let's look at the last example. Again, the first step is to simplify inside the innermost grouping symbols, which indicates the first step here is to determine 1 plus 3, which is 4. We now have 6 squared divided by the quantity 4 times 3 squared. Still working inside the grouping symbols, now the brackets. We have multiplication as well as exponents. We evaluate the exponents first. 3 squared equals 3 times 3, or 9, giving us 6 squared divided by the quantity 4 times 9. Still simplifying inside the brackets, we have 4 times 9. 4 times 9 is equal to 36. If we want to, we can drop the brackets now and write this as 6 squared divided by 36. We have exponents and division. Next step, we evaluate the exponents. 6 squared equals 6 times 6, which is 36. Giving us 36 divided by 36, which is equal to 1. I hope you found this helpful.